All right, I'm just gonna come out and say it. Colorado Springs sucks. Especially for someone who's lived up here in Northern Colorado for quite a while and has gone down and visited there. I've been in Parker, Colorado, lived there for a while, and I can tell you, if I had the choice and the option when I first lived down there, I would have rather chose to live up here in Northern Colorado and specifically Loveland. So today we're going to run through everything I think about in terms of why I believe Colorado Springs is not as good as up here in Northern Colorado, like Fort Collins and Loveland. My name is Connor Martin. I work with Sioux Cup Real Estate Services in Fort Collins, Colorado. I love making these videos to be able to get you guys the information about what the differences are on moving here, what to expect, what fun adventures there are to have here, some of the good back routes to drive when trying to avoid traffic when driving. So please, if you guys could come along, please like, share, comment. And today is gonna be all about Loveland, Colorado, Fort Collins, Colorado, versus Colorado Springs. All right, so we're gonna jump right on into it on why Fort Collins, Loveland is 10 times better to live in than Colorado Springs. So when kind of visiting Colorado Springs, I've been up there quite a bit. I got to live over on the southern side of Colorado in the Parker area, which is about an hour, hour and a half away from Colorado Springs. You know, I've been able to see the big differences between living up north here in Colorado or living down south. And one of the big ones is going to be size differences. It seems like there is a huge population growth that is happening on the southern side of Colorado. One, because of tech jobs, industries, and because of the amenities that southern side does bring. To me, the southern side of Colorado is a huge suburb. And that's what you'll hear a lot of people say about, like, Colorado Springs, for example, is it's a very large suburb. You know, they have over 400,000 people living in that city alone. It's 195 square miles, so it's a very vast, large area as well. So everything does feel spread out, but it also does take a lot more time to drive to different places, to get to different areas. And so just something to, you know, keep in mind on when you go and visit Colorado Springs, if you're ever thinking about moving up to the Colorado from a different state. It's one of the first things that a lot of people ask me from, you know, people who have moved from Chicago or Florida or New Mexico. They're sitting there saying, well, what's the difference between Colorado Springs and Fort Collins, Loveland, or Northern Colorado? Because they're kind of trying to decide between the two. And for me, Loveland, Fort Collins is a town. Colorado Springs is more of a suburb. You know, for us up here, we have around 250,000 people. And that's within Loveland, Fort Collins. We have everything that is nice and close to Loveland and Fort Collins for shopping, hiking, great restaurants, and it's all in this nice tight package, which is around 95 square miles, so roughly about 100 less than Colorado Springs. You know, our traffic is a lot less condensed, everything is close, so all our restaurants are kind of in certain sections. If it's downtown Loveland, downtown Fort Collins, or up at the shopping center in Fort Collins, or up in Sentara in Loveland, they kind of bunch everything together to where it's really easy to go in and get a meal, you know, go in and go shopping. Everything is nice and close. And for example, I live on the west side of Loveland, Colorado, and to get anywhere from where I'm at, you're looking at a 10 to probably 20 minute drive at the max to get anywhere to like I-25, Sentara, getting up to the foothills to go hiking, or, you know, to get up to like Estes Park up from Loveland is only roughly about a 30 minute drive. And so that to me is a huge benefit of living up here in Loveland and Fort Collins versus being in Colorado Springs. So my next big difference between Colorado Springs and Fort Collins and Loveland is going to be lakes. So for a lot of people who move up here to Loveland and Fort Collins, we are huge adventure people. We are very outdoorsy. We want to be close to the action and the fun. And so one of the big things, if you ever go onto Google Maps and you look at the difference between like the geography of Loveland, Fort Collins versus Colorado Springs, you're gonna tell that Fort Collins and Loveland have a lot of bodies of water around it. You know, there's only a few ones that are public, but when you're looking to go out and enjoy a day at the beach or go out and enjoy a day fly fishing or boating or paddle boarding, we have places that are close to all the towns here in this northern part of Colorado. So we have Carter Lake, we have Horseshoe Lake, we have Boyd Lake. Those are three of the ones that you can actually have motorized boats on. If you're looking to do fly fishing, we have the Pewter Canyon. We have the Big T up the drive on Highway 34 up to Estes Park. You know, we have everything in terms of body of water that you would have very close to you, and it makes it really enjoyable on that side. If you're looking to go out and do like hunting or anything like that, we're very close to national land. Roosevelt National Park is a great place to go up and do hunting. If you're looking to go out and just do some shooting in the afternoon, going up the Pewter Canyon Highway 14 is a good option. Or going out to the Pawnee Butte grasslands, which is also a great area to go out and do dirt biking during the winter time, and to go out and shoot shotguns and other weapons. So just something to kind of think about on that side.